Hello everyone, and welcome to the 2019 Year Update and Q&A. I have a lot of things to talk about today, so let's dive right in. First, let's start with a brief recap of some of the things that happened in 2018, and then we'll touch on what you can expect to see in 2019. But before we begin, just a friendly reminder to make sure you have the bell notification checked and select the Updates for All Posts option. I've been getting some messages from people saying that YouTube is not sending out notifications when my videos are posted. I always post on Fridays at 9 a.m. Pacific time, so you can always stop by the channel page then to see my latest uploads. Anyway, on to the year update. The channel continued to grow more than ever this last year, gaining more than 150,000 new subscribers and over 100 million video views. Thanks for all the support to all of my fans, and a warm welcome aboard to those of you who joined me this last year. Additionally, the channel celebrated its 10th anniversary on YouTube in September with a month of extra Trains Galore highlight reel videos. 2018 was a year of many improvements for CoasterFan 2105. As part of the 10-year anniversary, I announced that I was officially upgrading to 4K 60 frames per second video. I have already started to upload all new 4K videos, and I will continue to do so into the new year. I still have some HD videos that need to be posted, but my hope is to go almost exclusively 4K by 2020. To help me with editing the very large 4K video clips, I have also replaced my computer. This should help me edit videos faster than ever, and should also improve the quality of the finished videos. Earlier in 2018, at the request of many, I finally created an Instagram account. When I first created the account, I was posting a lot of different photos from my collection, but I think I will mainly be using it for recently taken photos to keep you updated as to what I'm currently doing. I also received a lot of requests to set up a Teespring store, so I did that as well. I still have some adjustments to make, but I've put up quite a few different shirts, posters, and mugs. If you want to check it out, take a look at the link in the description. Finally, in November of last year, I started posting videos regularly to Facebook on the CoasterFan 2105 page. These videos will mostly be re-edits and compilations of video clips that have already been posted on YouTube, but I will occasionally post some new clips that will eventually end up on YouTube as well. The Facebook content usually comes out on Monday mornings at 9 a.m. Pacific time, so if you're interested, head over to the CoasterFan 2105 Facebook page. That does it for the 2018 recap. Now on to what's coming down the line in 2019. Let's start off with trip plans. My first trip of the year is going on right now if you're watching this video the first weekend it comes out. I'm on a quick trip to the upper Midwest to catch a steam locomotive that a lot of people have requested for quite a while. I don't want to spoil the surprise yet, but if all goes as planned, you may see a special video early next month. Depending on the weather and my luck, I'm also hoping to catch the new F-59 PHI locomotives now in service with Metra. Once I get back from the Midwest, things get a little interesting. As most of you probably know, the Union Pacific Railroad has almost completed the restoration of the famous steam locomotive Big Boy No. 4014. The general plan is for the 4014 to run to Ogden, Utah at the beginning of May to celebrate the 150th anniversary of the completion of the Transcontinental Railroad this year. So far, no specific plans for this have been announced, but I fully intend on following the Big Boy on this journey. Some of you may remember that last year I promised I would visit Florida, but unfortunately I wasn't able to do that. So I am in the process of planning a mega trip this April and May. As of right now, my plan is to visit Florida during the first half of April, then spend a little bit of time in Texas and probably some other places in between, finishing off at the Big Boy at the beginning of May. This trip is still very much in the early stages of planning and subject to change depending on what ends up happening with the Big Boy and any possible test runs that might happen. After that, I don't really have anything planned yet, but if you have any requests for the second half of the year, let me know in the comments below. In addition to all of these travel plans, the first half of the year, I will also be moving. This is one of the reasons I don't have any plans for the second half of this year yet, as the move has taken up a lot of my time for the last several weeks. Once I'm done with that, I should have a better idea of what I will be doing for the rest of the year. Finally, let's discuss some of the videos you will be seeing this year. By popular demand, I am once again planning on a Toy Trains Galore and a Steam Trains Galore later on this year, and possibly one or two other Galore videos. I'm also hoping to bring back the series Train Talk in March with a special episode on a passenger diesel locomotive, followed by two special episodes for the 150th anniversary of the Transcontinental Railroad in April and May. One of my most popular uploads last year was the full-length video of the Amtrak Coast Starlight. Because of this, I am in the process of putting additional videos together on some of the other long-distance Amtrak trains. I am hoping to have the next one done sometime this summer. Speaking of longer narrated videos, I have another poll question for you. Do you prefer the longer narrated videos I have done like the Coast Starlight, or do you like the shorter episodes of Train Talk? Or would you like to see an all-new narrated video series on tourist railroads or something like that? Vote in the poll by clicking on the circular eye icon in the top right corner of the video and let me know what you'd like to see. In addition to the Big Boy Trip and the special episodes of Train Talk, I am also planning on releasing one steam train video a month for the Transcontinental Railroad anniversary. There won't be a steam video this month, but I'm planning on posting at least one every month from February through the end of the year. Finally, I have received a lot of requests for more regular toy train and model train videos. My original plan for this year was to do one toy or model train video every month. Unfortunately, because of the move, I've had to pack all of the trains that I use in these videos away for the time being. However, I'm hoping that I will be able to start making more of these videos this February. If I'm able to do that, I should have one toy or one model train video posted every month from March through the end of the year. And certainly by next year, this will become a regular part of the schedule. Well, that was a lot of info. Now that we're finally done with all of that, it's time to go through some questions. What is your favorite state to railfan in? I don't really have a favorite state in particular. I've found a lot of great photo locations in pretty much every state. Will you do any boats videos in February or March? I don't currently have plans for more boat videos, but that is always subject to change. The next non-train video you will probably see on this channel will be airplanes. What is your favorite electric locomotive, your favorite Amtrak route, your favorite freight locomotive on BNSF, and what happened to the Pacific Parlor cars on the Coast Starlight? My favorite electric is the AEM7, my favorite Amtrak route is the Coast Starlight, my favorite BNSF freight locomotive is the SD70i, and the Pacific Parlor cars were retired from service and auctioned off last November. What is your favorite train? My favorite train of all time is the Southern Pacific Coast Daylight. Of the trains that are currently running, probably the Amtrak Coast Starlight. Do you have any plans to come out east and film New Hope and Ivyland number 40 and Western Maryland Scenic Railroad 1309 when it comes back? And are you planning on going to see the Berkshires 1225 and 765? Yes, that's actually one of the things I'm considering doing this fall, depending on what else is going on and if the 1309 is done yet or not. I would like to see 765. And as for 1225, check back on this channel at the beginning of February for your answer. If you can film more of Southern Pacific 4449, can you do a compilation for the engine's birthday? Yeah, I'd like to get more 4449 eventually. Hopefully it'll do some more excursions this year. Will you film Huckleberry Railroad number 152? Yeah, probably very soon actually. Have you ever seen Challenger 3985 or UP9000? Yeah, I've seen both of them, but it was a number of years ago. What plans do you currently have for 2019? Is there a train that you don't want to see? How do you feel about Amtrak F-59s leaving California? So far, the two trips that I mentioned earlier on the video, and possibly something over the summer and in the fall. I'm sad to see the F-59s, but I'm happy they're going to a good use. Hey Mike, what are your plans for the 150th anniversary of the Transcontinental Railroad with UP 4014 and 844. My plan is to chase the train from Ogden and then possibly more after that depending on how much time I have. Hey Uncle Mike, what are you doing now? Well, right now I'm editing this video. 1. Do you have any model trains? And 2. Will you come to Orlando, Florida? Yes, I do have model trains, and if I come to Florida this April as I have planned, I will definitely be stopping off in Orlando for a few days. SP4449 or UP Big Boy. I like both of them, but 4449 has always been my favorite steam locomotive. Can you do an edit of steam locomotive like Rocky Mountain Express? I'd love to do a full documentary like that, but it would probably be very expensive and time-consuming to put something like that together. What may be a possibility is a full-length narrated video on a particular steam locomotive or steam railroad, like what I did with the Coast Starlight video last year. What is your most favorite Amtrak line? Long distance would be the Coast Starlight, and Intercity is a tie between Pacific Surfliner and Amtrak Cascades. What is your favorite railroad on the East Coast? In terms of the two major ones, probably Norfolk Southern, although I do like CSX a lot too. Favorite steam engine, Southern Pacific 4449. I have a few questions, if that's okay. What are your thoughts about Amtrak's F-59 PHI locomotives being sold to Metra? Are you planning on traveling to Canada anytime 2019 to film Go Transit via another trains? Do you plan on doing a train talk episode on Los Angeles Metrolink commuter railroad, since you did episodes on both Coaster and Pacific Surfliner? Also, how are you liking Instagram? For the F-59s, I think that anytime equipment can be reused somewhere else, it's a good thing, and it should happen more often. I'm definitely hoping to go to Canada this year, and it will most likely happen because after I move, I will be pretty close to Canada. In terms of a train talk episode on Metrolink, potentially, yeah, that's always a possibility. And as for Instagram, so far, I'm liking it just fine. Since the Coast Starlight is your favorite Amtrak Western long-distance route, what is your favorite Eastern long-distance route? Probably the Cardinal. Favorite Arizona railroad? I really like the Black Mesa and Lake Powell. If we're including tourist railroads, probably the Grand Canyon Railway too. Are you going to do Metrolink in Ventura? I will probably film it more at some point, but not sure if it will end up as an individual video. Favorite heritage unit? For Amtrak, the 822 Phase 3 unit. For Union Pacific, the 1996 Southern Pacific unit. And for Norfolk Southern, the 1066 New York Central unit. Can you horn battle trains in Jack London Square? Not sure about doing something in Jack London Square, but possibly somewhere else. Are you still rail fanning the Metra Electric line during the rush hour? I hope to eventually. Not sure if I will be doing that on my current trip, but if I have time, I'll try. I will be in Durango, Colorado, then I'm going to Utah for the Golden Spike in 2019. I wonder, could you do a video for basically both of those? I will most likely be doing videos for both of those this year. Just watched and enjoyed the video on the Pacific Surfliner, so what do you expect for the Pacific Surfliner in the future beyond what has been said? I've heard a lot of different scenarios, such as express service, local service making even more stops, and increased service frequency. Hello, will you make a video about the New River train? If I ever go to the East in the fall, definitely. Are you also going to be railfanning the Metra's Rock Island, BNSF, and Union Pacific lines at rush hour too? I probably will. What is your favorite steam train in the world? Southern Pacific 4449. Will you be able to film Milwaukee Road 261? Depending on when and where it runs, I hope so. I have another question. What is your favorite spot to railfan and why? I really like the Del Mar Cliffs in San Diego and the BNSF rail line along Puget Sound. Both have great scenery and a lot of trains. Hello Mike, how old are you? How long have you been rail fanning? And at what age did you start to become interested in trains? I'm in my mid-20s, I've been filming since December of 2002, and I've been interested in trains since I was a very young kid. CoasterFan2105, I got a few questions for you. What is your favorite railroad? What is your favorite train horn? Do you like EMD or GE better? What are your top three favorite Amtrak heritage units? What are your top three favorite Norfolk Southern heritage units? What are your top three favorite Union Pacific heritage units? What is your favorite EMD locomotive? And what is your favorite GE locomotive? Favorite railroad is the Alaska Railroad. Favorite horn is the Nathan K5 LA. I think they have both made good locomotives over the years, but of my favorite diesels, more of them are EMD, so I'm probably going to go with EMD. Top three three Amtrak Heritage units are 822, 184, and 156. If you count 406, that would be on the list as well. For Norfolk Southern, it would be the New York Central 1066, the Southern 8099, and the Erie 1700. For Union Pacific, it's SP 1996, Rio Grande 1989, and the Katy 1988. Favorite EMD locomotive is the F40PH. My favorite GE locomotive is the P32-BWH. What is the schedule for the 2019 year? For videos, I only have a rough schedule right now, and it depends on what I'm able to film. The only two trips I have planned so far are the ones I mentioned in the update part of the video. Any chance of an Electric Trains Galore 2? It's possible, but not likely, at least right now, for two reasons. The first is that there aren't that many electric trains in the United States, and I filmed almost all of them for the original Electric Trains Galore. If I were to do another one, I would probably have to film electric trains in other countries. The second reason there won't be another one, at least for now, is that it was one of my least favorite Trains Galore videos, and since they take so much time to film, I would probably be better off trying a new Galore video that hasn't been done before, or a sequel to one of the more popular ones. But never say never. What is your favorite Disneyland Railroad steam engine? What is your favorite Fallen Flag Railroad? And will you film Santa Fe number 2926? Favorite Disneyland engine is the E.P. Ripley. Favorite Fallen Flag is a tie between the Southern Pacific and Santa Fe. And yes, I will definitely film 2926 when it's done. Here are two questions for the Q&A. Do you like or hate quiet zones? And do you go railfanning by yourself or with some friends? I think for safety, grade separations are much better than quiet zones. I understand why people like them, but as someone who likes train horns, I prefer to film in areas that aren't quiet zones when possible. When I'm going to film, sometimes I go alone, and sometimes I go with other people. It just depends on the situation. Of all the steam locomotives that you haven't filmed, which one is at the top of your list to film? And have you ever considered doing a series about the do's and don'ts of rail fanning and chasing trains? Top steam locomotive to film is probably the Union Pacific 4014, and I've considered doing a general train photography tips video, but haven't gone any further with the idea yet. It's possible that I will end up doing it as a train talk episode later this year. Hey Mike, can you come to New York City to railfan? I was on Long Island and in some of the New York City suburbs last year, or I guess 2 years ago now. but I've always thought it would be fun to do a video on the subway at some point. Any chance of getting more frequent Toy Trains Galore videos? My kids love them. I'm not sure specifically about the Toy Trains Galore videos, but I would like to do Toy Train videos in general pretty regularly. My hope is to do some sort of Toy Train video once a month. Will you at some point do a Railroad Crossing Galore? And two, will you do a Train Talk Railroad Crossing equipment at some point too? Probably not as a Galore video, but I will most likely be doing a Trains and Railroad Crossings video. In terms of a Train Talk episode, that is also very likely. When is the next Train Talk episode scheduled for, and what is it about? The next Train Talk will hopefully be the first Friday in March if all goes as planned, and it should be about a diesel-electric passenger locomotive. No spoilers yet. Three questions. Will you railfan Bound Brook, New Jersey? Have you ever gotten told by a police officer to leave the spot you were railfanning? And will you do a face reveal? If I'm ever in New Jersey, I can try to go there. Not so much recently, but I have in the past been told to leave from a spot where I was filming, and I will be doing a face reveal at some point, and it will probably be for the 500,000 subscriber special. Have you considered doing trains in Texas? Yes, I have, and hopefully we'll be doing that this April. Electric or diesel, isn't it scary to have 100 plus decibel horn honk so close to you when railfanning? Favorite Eastern long distance train? Favorite freight diesel? Union Pacific or BNSF? I'd say diesel, although I really like some electric locomotives. The horns can be startling if you aren't expecting the noise. Favorite Eastern long distance train would be the Cardinal. Favorite freight diesel is probably the SD70 Mac or the GP40. And I go back and forth between Union Pacific and BNSF. What is is your favorite heritage railroad? The Cumbres and Toltec Scenic Railroad. 1. Can you rail fan in Lupton, Arizona? 2. Have you heard the EAS on TV? And 3. Do you know Nicholas S? I have actually filmed not that far from Lupton before, and there's a good chance I'll be back eventually. Yes, I've heard the EAS many times over the years, and not off the top of my head. What is your favorite EMD, GE, or Alco locomotive? And your favorite cab car? Favorite EMD is the F40PH, favorite GE is the P32-BWH, and favorite Alco is the PA. When I was a kid, my favorite cab car was Coaster 2303. I'm not sure what I'd pick now. When will you do a Via Rail video? I'm hoping to film Via Rail this summer. There may not be a full Via Rail video until later, but it will probably make appearance in something later this year. If you have a railfan Metra, freight, Amtrak, or other commuter trains, can you get more horn salutes? I do get horn salutes from time to time. One of the issues is that in cities, people will often complain about the noise, so a lot of train crews don't like to do that. When will you come back to the San Joaquin Valley? I was there last October, but possibly again this year. Train horn video with your collection? Yes, I'm absolutely planning on doing that, but it might not be until next year. Do you ever plan to go overseas for rail fanning? I don't have firm plans right now, but I would like to. What got you into your hobby of trains? The first thing I can think of is a video about the Southern Pacific 4449 called Daylight Express that my grandmother got for me years ago when I was very young. I've been hooked ever since. Can you also make a train talk video of how to know when a train excursion is going to happen? Maybe. There are a few websites that I recommend checking regularly to see when steam events are coming. One is called Steam Train Diaries, and the other is the RailServe.com special steam events calendar. If you come back to New Jersey, will you visit Bound Brook, and will you ever do a face reveal? I will possibly visit Bound Brook, and I am planning on doing a face reveal. How do you find out where trains are for you? Do you use ATCS or do you use a radio? If you use a radio, what do you have? Currently, I don't use either, but I'm in the process of getting a new radio. Usually when I'm out filming freight trains, I have friends that either have a radio or a scanner. What are your thoughts on Richard Anderson, president of Amtrak? I think he's trying to do a good job managing Amtrak. I'm not sure how I feel about all of the changes he's trying to make, but for now I'm going to wait and see what happens. What is your favorite place to film trains? Either the Delmar Cliffs or the BNSF line along Puget Sound. Opinions on Ohio Central 6325. It's a neat locomotive and I hope to see it running again someday. Why did you make your name Coaster Fan 2105? As a kid, I had a model that I still have actually of San Diego Coaster Locomotive number 2105, so by default that became my favorite coaster locomotive. So, way back when I was coming up with a username, I just decided on Coaster Fan 2105 because the coaster has been my local commuter railroad for all the years I've lived in San Diego. Train traveling 70 miles an hour leaves San Diego heading toward Los Angeles 260 miles away. At the same time, train traveling 60 miles an hour leaves Los Angeles heading toward San Diego. When do the trains meet? What is your favorite color? Do you wear socks to go to sleep? Well, I guess that depends if either of the trains breaks down or not. My favorite color is green, and if it's cold, yes, I do. Would you consider going to the Kansas City Union Station? They have a nice bridge that goes over the tracks. I actually went to Kansas City last year and filmed from the very bridge you mentioned. You can see it in the 2018 Year in Review video. How did it feel to chase the Coast Starlight? It was pretty neat. I actually chased it several different times in order to have enough clips to film the Coast Starlight video. Best part slash catch of 2018? Probably seeing Union Pacific 844 on the Frontier Days train. Where will you be going in 2019? Illinois, Michigan, Texas, Florida, Colorado, Wyoming, Utah, and probably more. Do you have any plans to come up to the Connecticut shoreline section of the Northeast Corridor? If I end up making an East Coast trip this fall, I'm gonna make every effort to do so. Maybe I'll even do some sort of a fan-planned trip and let people tell me where they'd like me to go and on which days. Have you ever been interested in filming other types of trains like monorails, trams, trolleys, streetcars? I like filming those types of trains too and have done so in the past. There may actually be another trolley video coming in February or March. What is your favorite smaller train station? What is your favorite freight train company? Do you plan on coming up to stations like San Jose and Santa Clara in the near future? I've always liked the Little Depot in Carlsbad, California. My favorite modern railroad in general, including freight, is the Alaska Railroad. And I don't have any plans for San Jose or Santa Clara, but I have a lot of friends who live in the area, so I'll probably be there sooner or later. Which do you prefer on Amtrak's Pacific Surfliner, either the F-59 PHI or the SC-44 Charger? Oh, I think you know the answer to that. It's the F-59 PHI. I know you loved the AEM-7. We had them for a long time here in Philadelphia for SEPTA. Any opinions on their replacement, Siemens ACS-64? The ACS-64 seems like a decent locomotive. I've heard they've been pretty reliable for Amtrak, so hopefully they are for SEPTA too. Will you ever visit Yreka and Montague near Mount Shasta to see what's left of the old Yreka Western Railroad? Please answer if the MODOK line, formerly operated by the Southern Pacific, is still used by the Union Pacific. It's always a possibility. I pass through there quite often. I think what's left of the old MODOK line is currently being leased to a short line railroad. Would you ever come visit NorCal again, like the Sacramento-Roseville area? Yes, I'll definitely visit NorCal again. F-59 PHI or SC-44? F-59 PHI. What's your favorite K5LA variant? I like the 80s K5LAs off the F-40s and the 1996 square tag K5LAs. Well, I also really like the early 1980s K5LAs. The 90s ones are pretty good too. What train was that in the photo? That's McLeod 25 on the Oregon Coast Scenic Railroad. Hey, Coaster, do steam trains still exist? Yes, they do indeed. I have often wondered how you get so many shots of the same train from different spots along its route. Do you have extra cameras set up or take shots over multiple days, or are you simply faster than a locomotive? And do you know all the train schedules, or you just happen upon them sometimes? Well, yes to all three of those. I have a second camera that I will typically use to film an extra angle at most spots. I also usually film multiple days in certain spots, and sometimes, if it's a possibility, I'll chase the train to get ahead of it to another location further down the line. With the passenger trains, it's pretty much a combination of the schedule and checking on the train status on the internet. With others, I either get the info beforehand that a train is coming, or I just happen to be lucky. What camera do you use? The cameras I use now for 4K are Canon XF400s. When are you ever going to visit Steamtown? I don't know when, but I absolutely want to. Maybe this fall if I make an East Coast trip. Two questions. Is rail fanning for YouTube your job, or is it part-time? And how long does it typically take to record one video? When I first started, it was just for fun. Then it was a part-time thing while I was finishing college. And at this point, it's a full-time thing and it takes up most of my time. In terms of how much time per video, it really depends on the video. I've been able to film some videos in one day and edit them the same evening, while others have taken me months or in some cases years to film and then put together. I think the record probably goes to my Coast Starlight video last year. I used clips from as far back as 2013 for that video. That said, I wasn't planning that far in advance to make the video. I just happen to use a lot of clips from my archive. If we had time for only one, Cumbres and Toltec or the Durango and Silverton, and why? It depends on what kind of an experience you want. The Cumbres and Toltec has a much more authentic and open feeling to it. There's just so much original equipment that's still there and many old structures still standing. It's a very unique experience. Durango is a very nice ride, and the town is much bigger, so if you're looking to do things other than the railroad that aren't far away, you might consider that one. Personally, I would probably give the edge to the Cumbres and Toltec, but both are very fun and very much full-day experiences. Can you tell me the location at 4 minutes 30 seconds? That is a small grade crossing south of Mattoon, Illinois, on the Canadian National Main Line. Are you related to Neil Armstrong? No, not related. Train talk about old railroads. That's something I'd like to do, and if all goes as planned, you might see one this April.
April.
What was the best catch you had this year, and what are your plans for 2019? Probably Union Pacific 844. After you've done my request, catch all the Heritage and Veterans units. How about creating a video about all Amtrak California and Surfliner cab cars? Well, I could probably do that already with the clips that I've filmed. Is that something people would like to see? If so, let me know. What type of cameras do you use? XF400 currently, and in the recent past, the Canon XA10 and an XA25. What kind of steam engine is that, and what is the name of the railroad? That is a Class A Climax replica running on the Locust Heights and Western Railroad in Clarksburg, West Virginia. Hey man, I was wondering if you'll be going on any big trips in 2019, and maybe if we could make suggestions on where you could go. So far, just the two trips that I've mentioned, and absolutely you can make recommendations for future trips. Are you going to try to film both ATSF 2926 and UP Big Boy 4014 when they are both finally finished? Question 2, if by any chance there are plans for a doubleheader steam excursion with 3751 and 2926, or a tripleheader with 844, 3985, and 4014, will you try to be able to film both of those? And question 3, are you going to film other steam locomotives in the United Kingdom anytime soon? Yes, I hope to film both 2926 and 4014 when they're done. As for those excursions, unlikely that those things will happen, but if they do, I will certainly try to catch them. And I don't have any current plans, but I would like to go to the UK one day. When will you film in Florida? I'm really hoping for April. What's your advice to younger and upcoming rail fans? Don't be afraid to try different things, go to different locations, try different camera angles, try both static shots and panning or zooming with the train. Find out what works for you. Also study what other people have done in photos and videos posted online and see what you like best and try something similar. And of course, be safe and always be aware of your surroundings when you're out and about. I like the BNSF train at 1730. What kind of engines were those spaced through the train? Those are brand new EMD F125 locomotives being delivered to Metrolink. Check back next week for a video on the F125. CoasterFan2105, can you go to the Santa Fe Depot in San Diego? Can you go to Rockville, Maryland and video the Amtrak, Mark, and the Metro? When was the last time you rode Amtrak? I was at the Santa Fe Depot a couple weeks ago, didn't get anything moving, but I did catch an F-59 sitting in front of the depot. I've been to Rockville before and I liked it. I'll probably be back next time I film Mark. And I actually haven't ridden Amtrak in a couple years because I've been so busy filming. The last time I can clearly remember was the Acela Express in 2015, but I'm hoping to do a few Amtrak trips this year if I have time. Number 1, how do you earn money to travel to all of these rail fanning hotspots? And 2, what's your favorite steam train? The money I get to keep this channel going is pretty much all through the Google ads that are displayed on these videos and through YouTube Red. I also license individual video clips to people from time to time, and my favorite steam train is the Southern Pacific 4449. What type of cameras do you use? How do you record your voice on most of your videos, and how many Siemens Charger SC44 locomotives have you filmed so far in 2018? I just upgraded to Canon XF400s. To record my voice, I use a Blue Yeti microphone and record directly with my editing software. In terms of the Chargers, I've filmed probably 5 or 6 of the Midwest ones, 6 of the Cascades ones, and 2 of the Amtrak California ones, and then 10 of the Pacific Surfliner ones. What do you think about New Jersey Transit getting 113 new cars? If you had a favorite train that is electric, what would it be? If you had to pick a station you dreamed to see, what would it be? I liked the old Aero 3 cars, but I'm glad to see investment in new equipment, and hopefully some of the old cars will go to museums. My favorite electric is hands down the AEM7, and I've been by it before, but I'd like to probably further explore the Denver Union Station at some point. Seems like a pretty neat building. What is your favorite place to go in California? What is your favorite railroad museum? What is your favorite steam locomotive, and why? why, what got you interested in trains in general, and what other railroads and places would you like to go to in 2019? What is your favorite video on your channel, and what is your favorite heritage unit, diesel locomotive, and why? Would you like to go to New Orleans one day to see Southern Pacific 745? Would you like to go see 2472 again? Would you like to see Per Marquette 1225, Nickel Plate Road 765, Milwaukee Road 261, and Blue Mountain Redding 425? Favorite place to film in California is Del Mar. I think in terms of presentation, the California State Railroad Museum is probably the best in the country, followed by the Pennsylvania Railroad Museum. In terms of collection, my top two picks are the Illinois Railroad Museum and the Baltimore and Ohio Railroad Museum. Southern Pacific 4449 is my favorite steamer because of the video I got when I was a kid. Plus, I think the design of it is very eye-catching. The Daylight Express video from Skyfire is what got me interested in trains. In 2019, I want to see 4014, several different railroads in Florida and Texas, and hopefully some of the railroads in Canada and the Northeast. My favorite video on my channel. Hard for me to pick one, but I think I'm going to go with the Amtrak Coast Starlight video I did last year. My favorite heritage unit is Amtrak 822 because I really like the Phase 3 paint scheme. I've always wanted to see 745, but it's been very difficult to figure out when it's going to run. It would be neat to see 2472 run again, but it probably won't happen for a while. And yes, I would like to see all of those, one of which I should be seeing very soon. Where will you be traveling in 2019? And if you haven't, can you do a video on the Tweetsie Railroad? Travel plans, as mentioned previously, and I have not been to the Tweetsie, but I would like to. How long have you been railfanning? I've been filming trains since December of 2002. However, even before that, I used to go to the Old Town Transit Center and watch trains go by in the mid to late 1990s. Well, that does it for the 2019 year update and Q&A. Thanks to all of you who submitted questions. I'm looking forward to all the exciting things that lie ahead. Let's make 2019 the best year yet. Until next time, I'm Mike Armstrong. I'll see you down the line. Thanks for watching.